hospitals, schools, hostels and colleges. The organization that I come from, BAPS, we have got a permanent seat in the United Nations as an NGO in the Socio-Economic Council on the consultative status. So we have been involved in more than 162 different kinds of social activities, cultural activities, environmental activities, health activities, moral activities throughout the world with a volunteer force of more than 55,000. And we are about 1,000 saints in the organization. More than 700 of them are graduates, postgraduates, chartered accountants, doctors, engineers. We have more than about 100 saints who have been Oxford graduates, Stanford, Yale, and Harvard graduates in the organization at the age of 25, 30, 35. So as Rotary, we also do all types of activities throughout the world. But when I'm specially told that the Swaminarayan Akshardham at New Delhi, which is an epitome of Indian culture, an epitome of services, selfless services, forget the right hand doing and the left hand not knowing, right ventricle of the heart doing and left not knowing, we work on that principle. Even the right ventricle, it pumps the blood, the left ventricle of the heart doesn't know it. The case study of Akshardham at New Delhi, first giving you the physical features in a couple of minutes about Akshardham. It's a 100-acre campus. The entire campus we build with every inch of land well developed in 5 years. It is a non-residential, non-commercial project. When I was talking to a few estate developers about a couple of weeks back in their national conference, I asked them, any real estate developer in the country or anywhere in the world who has developed 100 acres of land, absolutely non-commercial, non-residential, and stone construction in 5 years, just raise your hand. And nobody could. Along with that, the main monument, which is about 850,000 cubic feet of pink stone. We have three wonderful exhibitions, the audio animatronic shows, audio animatronic dioramas with the latest technology. We have the wonderful boat ride, where in 10 minutes of boat ride, you see 10,000 years of human history. We have the lush green gardens where you have great luminaries from different fields who have been foundation in building the greatness of India over the years and centuries. So it's a wonderful campus where people get inspired in all walks of life. And the main monument, Akshardham, is about 3 lakh pieces of carved stones. It's like a huge jigsaw puzzle brought together in just 5 years. I want to tell you the journey of Akshardham, which could inspire us all. The stories of Akshardham, which could inspire us all in a way that how we can better our organizations and our activities, public image in the hearts and minds of people. There is a big difference between public image and publicity. If you go for the publicity of your activities, you will never grow into a great organization. But if you go for the betterment of public image in the hearts and minds of your people, you will grow as an organization. So don't go for publicity, yet you can improve your public image to a large extent. We never gave a single advertisement of Akshardham in the newspapers. We have not printed leaflets to distribute it in the public. And yet, we have 17,000 people visiting every day. It's an average since last 12 years of its opening, visited by more than 125 heads of states on power in the last 12 years. Presidents and prime ministers of different countries. The who's who of the world have come there. That is because of the public image of Akshardham. What is that? How did it got created? How is it getting sustained? And how it is growing day by day? It's a wonderful journey and story. The Guinness Book of World Records has written that it is the largest functional Hindu mandir of the world. The story of the public image of Akshardham is the story of determination, dedication, and discipline, part one. It's a story of unity and commitment, part two. It's a story of synergy and selfless service, part three. This has created the public image of Akshardham. We never got into its publicity. The first story of dedication, discipline, determination is spread the knowledge. Story number one. As Rotarians, you must spread the knowledge of what you are actually for. What is the aim behind all your activities? Why do you do it for the people? Where do you reach out? And what are the outcomes of it? During that, not just a very clear demarcation that I would like to tell you all Rotarians is, a larger part of the activities of most of the organizations, they go into the help-based activities, need-based activities. I want to tell you today, go more on empowering activities. That will create a big public image. Need-based activities like blood donation camps, this, that, absolutely necessary. More than need-based activities, more than help-based activities, go for empowering-based activities. That is what we did at Akshardham during its journey of construction. The entire plan, when it was drawn up, it came to a conclusion that Param Pujya Pramukh Swami Maharaj, the inspirer of Akshardham, he said that I want to complete the project in 5 years. Now, if we wanted to complete it in 5 years, we would need 7,000 stone artisans. We searched entire Rajasthan, entire Orissa, and we could get only 1,000. If 1,000 artisans would work 12 hours a day, it would take 35 years, according to the Sompuras, the community who designed stone structures. But our Guruji Pramukh Swami Maharaj, he wanted it to be done in 5 years. So now it was the first big roadblock, rather a stone block. What we do? And we went up to Pramukh Swami Maharaj and said, Swami, this is the practical situation. And he said a very fine thought. He said, cannot we prepare another 6,000 artisans? Now this was a mammoth task of empowering people with an art. Stone chiseling, it's an art. You cannot teach people it overnight. Pramukh Swami Maharaj said, let us spend the first few months of this 1,000 artisans teaching another 6,000. Those 6,000 should be such that they should have this art in their ancestry. Go from village to village in Rajasthan, village to village in Orissa. There would be people who must have put aside this art because they might not be getting the jobs in this particular field. They might be doing something else since last 5 years, 10 years, 15 years or one generation. Pick them up and tell them that this is your ancestral art. We would teach you and we could give you at least a 5-year job. This is something extraordinary that cannot come into an ordinary mind. And we started searching. For that, as we have a good volunteer force, more than about 2,000 volunteers, they dedicated full 20 days of their time for this particular project. And we picked up more than about 8,000 people. Many of them were farm laborers. And we started more than 26 sites in Rajasthan, where in the first 6 months, this trained 1,000 artisans would teach these 6,000 people. So in 6 months, we created an art designing workforce of 7,000 people, which we wanted. When this incident came out, thousands and thousands of people, well-wishers, it touched their hearts that actually with this project we have empowered people as farm laborers. I'm talking of the year 2000-2001 in Rajasthan and Orissa, they were making just about 1500 to 2000 rupees a month. Now as artisans at Akshardham, they started making 10,000 rupees a month. And they, along with their family, got employed. The women folk, we took care of them. And we said for the stone polishing, after the stones were carved, we would employ your family members, the women folk. So the women folk got employed as well in the stone finishing. They also started making 4,000 rupees a month. So the family that was earning just 2,000 rupees started earning more than 15,000 rupees a month. So when you go to empower people, not just need-based activities, not just project-based activities, not just help-based activities, do activities that could empower people lifetime. That will create a very strong public image of your organization everywhere. So story number one teaches this, empowering activities. Lean more towards it. Now what happened? It was a jigsaw puzzle. 3 lakh stones to be carved for the main monument alone. The minimum wastage in this stone carving is estimated to be 30 to 40% all over the world, wherever the stone carving is done. Pramukh Swami Maharaj said we should go below 5%. Now again a mammoth task. Here starts story number two. What we did was, we made POP models of these 3 lakh stones. Actually, when they are carved and the design that they present, that design, that shape and size, we created POP models. We had more than about 50 saints fully involved in it, in all the departments. And then, when the stones, they came out from the quarries, according to the size and the shape of that stone, we would try to fit in the maximum carved stones, POP models that could be made out from that particular block. And then according to the small machines, each of this was cut out. For the first time in the history of stone carving, the chiseled out wastage was less than 5% after the 5-year project. So actually what was going to happen? If we hadn't done this, of the donors' money, I'm now coming to the point. Of the donors' money, 40 paisa of every rupee was going to get wasted. Because 30 to 40% of the stone gets wasted in stone carving. If you do not perform at this level and design at this level. For the first time in the history, we did this. And when that cut out stone, a block, was given to the artisan to work upon, he was given along with it what to be carved out from that stone in a perfect 3D image. That was done for the first time. We almost put more than 40 supercomputer types of technology at work for this. So the artisan constantly had that in mind. And the less than 5% stone that was chiseled out into small or big pieces was used as a foundation for the construction of our campus in Jaipur. So now almost 0% wastage of that stone, which is a world record. Now how it created a public image? When the donors came to know that we applied this technology, this process and this pragmatic thinking into it, this practical process innovations into it, they were more enthused to join more happily because they came to know that all the 100 paisa of their entire rupee was utilized for the purpose. So that created a public image. It bettered our public image in the hearts and minds of our donors. So chapter number two is this. If your donor comes to know and if it is convinced that all the 100 paisa of my entire rupee goes to the actual down the line recipient of the project, then he'll more happily join. This is very much necessary. The third part of the story is, we do projects, but we are less. I found it done many organizations that personal touch and personal care misses to quite an extent. For example, you do a healthcare camp, and 200 recipients of that camp could benefit from it. After the camp, after the project, maybe we are maintaining a good list of the recipients. But how many of those got a personal touch from you as a Rotarian? How many of them did you meet them personally? Personal care and personal touch gives a good public image, apart from our projects and services. I repeat the last sentence. Apart from your services and projects, your personal touch to people, personal care to people, gives a good public image. You don't need publicity after that. Those people would carry your public image back home in their communities. You would be surprised to know that our Guruji Pramukh Swami Maharaj, who created this Akshardham at the age of 83 in 2003, when the whole project was at its full bloom going on, he decided to visit all the 26 sites in Rajasthan. We said, Swamiji, this is not possible. It's May month and it's hot summer. It's difficult for you to go at all these places. He said, I want to meet all the 7,000 artisans personally at the age of 83. This is public image. And at the age of 83, Pramukh Swami Maharaj went to Rajasthan, visited all the 26 sites, hot, dusty sites. And you would be surprised to know the fact that Pramukh Swami Maharaj placed petals of roses or rose on the heads of each and every 7,000 artisans and telling them that what you create is going to be idols at Akshardham. There people would put petals at their feet. I am putting petals on your head because you have created it. At the age of 83, personal touch, personal care of 7,000 artisans. Those 7,000 artisans took back in their heart after the project that image of Pramukh Swami Maharaj, that if the leader can devote so much amount of time, so much amount of energy into the project, it could be a different thing. So when you do projects, when you do camps, when you do services, it's nice to cut the ribbon. It's nice to sit on the dais. It's nice to be next day in the newspapers, Times of India, fourth page was shown. It's nice. It's necessary. I'm not against it. At the same time, it is equally important to go to the recipients, meet them and spend time with them. The amount of time that you spend on the dais, minimum amount of time you must spend with the recipients, the smallest villagers, that is your public image building. Personal care, personal touch. Remember only these things. None of us is 83. Age. Huh? At least sitting here. Let me talk of the people around me. None of us is 83. If Pramukh Swami Maharaj at the age of 83 can go to Rajasthan and meet 7,000 artisans personally, can we meet the recipients of our projects personally? Yes or no? So next time when you do a health camp and there are 100 recipients of your project, you decide to meet all 100 if you are responsible for that health camp. Alone cutting the ribbon doesn't end the project. See, when you called me as a sadhu and telling me to talk about public image, how it develops concretely in the hearts and minds of people, apart from publicity and pictures. I must tell you, because we work at that level. We do that type of work. And we have done it at Akshardham when I'm asked to present the case study of it. So pragmatic thinking and practical process innovations. And personal care and personal touch gives a public image. It betters it, which is very much necessary. Another good part of the story is voluntarism. Time is very important. We have more than 55,000 volunteers dedicated full time. So when it was 2001 earthquake in Bhuj, on a single phone call, we had 1,500 volunteers who went to Bhuj. On the fourth day, on 30th January, we distributed 800 tons of relief materials in 509 villages of Kutch and Bhuj. So creating a strong volunteer force who do selfless services is one of the big keys for bettering your public image. Amount of time that you must dedicate, which is very much necessary. So this story headline says, strengthen your strengths. Strengthen your strengths. And one of the most important strengths, rather the foundation strength of any organization like ours or yours, is the amount of time that a volunteer dedicates to the organization. Are you ready to get up at any time from your office at 10 a.m., 12 noon, 4 p.m., 7 p.m. when a call from the Rotary comes? Just introspect. That kind of volunteerism is needed. Akshardham case study. The chief engineer at Akshardham was Ashwin Bhai Patel. He is an IIT Delhi graduate. He had his own construction company in Delhi. But when Pramukh Swami Maharaj just called him and said, Ashwin Bhai, we want a full-time engineer at the site. Ashwin Bhai said, I am here, Swami. Swamiji said, it is like from morning 6 to evening 12. That is midnight. Swamiji, after putting down this phone, I am coming out of my office. I will enter my office after the inauguration of Akshardham. For 5 years, his managers ran the show at his office. And Ashwin Patel, for 5 years, from morning 6 to midnight, taking care of the 7,000 artisans and taking care of everything, he did it. And after that, a huge construction company, DLF, in Delhi, they wanted to hire him after 5 years. They hired him at a very huge pay because he was the chief engineer at Akshardham. Again, after 1.5 years, we had some construction work. And our elder son, Pujay Ishwacharan Swami, he called him. He said, Swami, I'll put a 3-month leave, doesn't matter. And he put a 3-month leave again back to Akshardham. Dedicated volunteers. Our Harsha Chavda, he's in Rajasthan since last 25 years. He brought out all the stones. Not a single rupee is being paid to him since last 25 years. He just is like us, not a saint, fully dedicated. Just 2 meals a day and 2 pairs of clothes. Simple. And he works. Today, we are building Akshardham in New Jersey at Robbinsville, which is bigger than Delhi. Many of you might have seen at Robbinsville. When that will be inaugurated in 2021 on the day of the fifth day of Diwali, that is Lab Pancham, at 10 a.m. in the morning, 2021. What is Vatican to Christians, what is Mecca to Muslims will be Akshardham for Hindus. It's that campus on 235 acres of land. And the stone and the marble comes from Europe. It is shipped from Europe. It comes to Gujarat. Kandla is a free trade zone. There it comes to Rajasthan. At present, more than 4,000 artisans are working on it. And the carved stone is shipped back to America. You can understand the logistics. And we are completing it in 5 years. It's bigger than Delhi Akshardham. Voluntarism. Selfless services. So for that, how does it create a public image? I want to tell you, as Rotarian, you must ask the first question that is in your pledge. Is this the truth? You must ask to yourself every night before you retire. have I dedicated 10% of my time, my resources and my money to Rotary? Faithfully put your hand on your heart. Ask the question to yourself. In any organization, a selfless service organization that Rotary is and VBAPS are, in any selfless service organization that you join yourself as a member, you must dedicate 10% of your resources, 10% of your time and 10% of your money to that organization. Only then you deserve to be a member of that organization. So when you have put your 10% of your income, 10% of your resources, your presence will attract donors. You don't need have to talk to people. If you have dedicated 10% of your lifetime to your organization, you don't need to tell volunteers, "Arey yaar, 10 volunteers chahiye, arey yaar, 15 chahiye, kal camp pe 5 to aa jao." Ye frantic calls jo subah mein karne padte hai na, wo nahi karte. I've been to more than 100 Rotaries organizations, more than 100 Lions organizations for talks, and we have done some very good joint projects in Bangalore. We do a joint project with the Lions International as well, our health camps and everything. Such service organizations. So we know how volunteerism is developed. So this is it. 10% of your resources, time and energy, money, you must put into your organization. Otherwise, you are not a complete Rotarian. Let me tell you a fact. Am I right or wrong? 10% dedication to hona hi chahiye in all walks of life into your organization. Only then you deserve the membership of that particular organization. If you cannot do it, you have come here for some other purpose, not for service. So the statement is, if you cannot dedicate your 10% of time, resources, energy and money to the organization that you are a member of, you are not a dignified member of that organization. You are something other and your purposes are different. This will not create a good public image. Because now people are not going to believe everything that they read in the media about our activities. When they meet the person of that organization, a volunteer of that organization, by his presence, by his talk, by his walk, by his appearance, by his facial expressions, by his body language, he will judge your organization. So everybody sitting here, you are a Rotary, just not a Rotarian. You are Rotary itself. As I am standing here, I am personified Akshardham. I must talk, walk, behave, think according to the dignity of my organization. And when you are conscious of the dignity of your organization, and when you are in the midst of people and behave accordingly, you create personified public image of your organization. You will not need to publicize. Seeing you, people will accept. Seeing you, people will follow the principles of your organization. This is also a very much fact. Now the public image created by Akshardham. When Mukesh Ambani, chairman of Reliance Industries, he visited Akshardham and spent more than like about 2 hours there. And he came to know about all these stories. The spread of the knowledge, the win-win situation for us, for the artisans, for the government. The pragmatic thinking, the practical process innovations, the volunteerism, the dedication discipline, the unity and the commitment that we put inside the project. Mukesh Ambani writes in the guest book that now the blueprint of Akshardham is ready, and Reliance, we are known the world over for time-bound projects. But I can tell you as chairman of Reliance Industries Limited that if even given the blueprint and the other resources, I don't think Reliance can build Akshardham in 5 years. The image he carried with him in his heart just in 2 hours visit. So now nothing to be told to him. I don't need to show him all the inauguration ceremony press cuttings. I don't need to show him. The way that the words that he has used, simple. When Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, as President of India, he visited Akshardham, he was the chief guest in the inauguration ceremony that was live telecast in 160 countries. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, when he came to know about all these stories, about the dedication, discipline, unity, commitment, everything, and the optimum utilization of donors' money also, every story, when he came to know, Abdul Kalam, he expressed himself in the inauguration ceremony and said, my dream of 1,000 people can mobilize these resources and create this extraordinary creation. I think if 1 billion people of India, they can come together with unity, commitment, dedication, discipline and determination and optimum use of all their resources, I think India can be a great country. He said, Akshardham is the role model. The stories of Akshardham is the role model for the development of India. What a public image. So this is it. I think I have just 5 minutes more left. Yeah, in last 5 minutes I complete. Okay. So this is the public image that has been created in the hearts and minds. When R.K. Lakshman, the Times of India first page, we used to read his cartoon every day for decades. When he came there and he went around the monument, he was in a wheelchair, our two volunteers escorting him, he was in tears. His wife, she saw him for the first time in tears. And with tears rolling down in his cheeks, he said, this is the place where I can experience tranquility. This is the place where I feel the presence of providence. And I think I have nothing to criticize or pass a funny comment here. I am convinced, I am fulfilled, I want to meet the Creator. A complete atheist, he comes to Akshardham, turns into a complete believer in God. R.K. Lakshman himself got very much impressed, and he has told to more than 200 of his friends of his strata about the glory of Akshardham. So we had R.K. Lakshman as our publicity man. We don't need any other publicity. This is the image, public image that Akshardham creates in the hearts and minds of people. The president of Kazakhstan, a Muslim nation, when he came to Akshardham and saw and got touched by the universal values of humanity that we have presented there and the stories behind the creation of it, he offered us straight away. Now I'm disclosing a big secret in public. The president of Kazakhstan straight away offered that you can come to Kazakhstan, pinpoint a 200-acre land, I will mobilize all my resources, create Akshardham in Kazakhstan. The Prime Minister of Nepal has written to us that create an Akshardham in Nepal. We will mobilize all your resources for you. The Chief Minister of Orissa, Biju Patnaik, was. The Chief Minister of Haryana, Mr. Hudda, was. They all offered us to create Akshardham at their places. See the public image. If you do it with these values and virtues, you are going to create it. You don't need publicity. This is again a fact. I tell you the last two incidents, that these values that we have put forward there, they have changed the lives of people. A couple living separately since last 2 years applied for divorce, 10 years marriage, 7 year kid, and their respective lawyers called them on Sunday, Saturday evening, that Monday morning you can come to the court with signatures, you can just mutually part out. At that time, the husband calls the wife and says, can we spend the last Sunday evening together? The wife says, okay, no issues. And then the wife asked the husband, where should we go? He says, let's go to a movie. She said, no, lot of movies we saw together. Let's go to Akshardham. They came to Akshardham. This was 2007, where they saw the diorama of Dashrath commanding Rama to leave the palace. Sitaji says, I will go with him. He's my husband. If my husband is the king, I am the queen. If my husband goes to the forest, I have to go with him. This diorama inspired both of them. They caught each other's hand emotionally. Our spot boy asked for help. They said, keep us alone. They went back to the garden, and then they both called their respective lawyers and said, we want to give a second thought to our marriage. The lady felt that I come in this rich heritage of Sita. The husband felt that I come in this rich heritage of Rama. And then They decided to stay for a few days together. Today, after 10 years, they are a happy couple and a happy family. Such one incident, every day 15 to 20 such incidents happen at Akshardham, where people understand each other better, people come close to each other, people decide to live together. This public image created, this couple now is our weekend volunteers. And they have introduced more than about 10 relatives of theirs to Akshardham, and one of them is also a volunteer in the organization. This is the public image you create when you touch the lives of people. So not just help people, not just fulfilling their needs, try to help and imbibe values in their lives, and that will create a better public image of the organization. So this is the case study of Akshardham, a journey through Akshardham, right from its creation stage to its fulfillment stage, and how, without a single ounce spread on its publicity, we have got a huge public image internationally that the presidents and heads of states are inviting us for creating in their nations, is just because of the rich values, rich virtues that have been put in its foundation, and it has created this. So my prayers for all of us, for me, for us, and for you all, we all are involved in the selfless service activities of our respective organizations, that we may talk, walk, behave in a way, we may do projects in a way that empower people, that imbibes values and virtues in people, and that is the biggest public image that you create. My all prayers at the feet of Bhagwan Swaminarayan and my Guru Hari Pramukh Swami Maharaj and Mahan Swami Maharaj, that he blesses us with this. Thank you very much.